brothers who gathered together this afternoon. We mark the 100th birthday of Blessed Mary Apostle of Moscow, founders of the missionary sisters of St. Peter. We join the sisters in celebrating with them on this awesome occasion. As we begin then to celebrate the sacred of the spouse of the Father, my dear
as nurslings, you shall be carried in her arms and For neither does circumcision do anything, nor does uncircumcision, but only a new creation. Peace and mercy be to all who follow this rule and to the Israel of God. From now on, let no one make troubles for me, for I bear the marks of Jesus on my body. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brothers and sisters. Amen. The word of the Lord.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise.
of the founders of the Sisters of St. Peter Claver. And we also pray thanksgiving to Paul VI on Mission Sunday, 1975, beatified. And we also today pray a special thanksgiving for someone we have with us, Sister Leonora, who celebrates 25 years of religious life. And I think we should thank her for her great gift. Reflecting on the scripture readings in light of this special day for the Sisters of St. Peter Claver, I hope you don't mind that I'm going to focus the readings on them, which is good for all the rest of you because it gives you a week off. You don't have to pay attention to what the Lord told us this week. And sisters, I'm sorry, you do. In that first reading from Galatians, Paul's letter, he captures really the spirit of the sister celebration. When he says, "May I never boast, save the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ." And with the sisters, we join St. Paul, and we too rejoice in the cross of Jesus. For we know that it is through our Lord's suffering and death and glorious resurrection that we have been saved from sin. Saved, if you will, from a meaningless, empty life, and saved from running towards nothing. Rather, with St. Paul, we can boast of the cross of Jesus, for it is through the Lord's suffering, death, and resurrection that we have been able to become a new creation and to focus on eternal life. The Sisters of St. Peter Claver, following the example of our Lord, have proclaimed the gospel faithfully through their missionary zeal. Like the 72 disciples of Jesus appointed, the sisters have announced the good news, following the instructions of the Lord. The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray therefore the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into the harvest. Go your way. Behold, I send you out as lambs in the midst of wolves. This is indeed a calling from the Lord. And this is a calling which rests in a special way on each one of us on the day of our baptism. And for some, like the Sisters of St. Peter Claver that we honor today, it expresses itself in a special call from the Lord, which we call a vocation. For Jesus wanted to give the 72 disciples in today's gospel, and to all those called to the consecrated life, the gift of confidence and the special grace to evangelize in his name. The sisters, with their radical commitment to Christ, through their vow of life of poverty, chastity, and obedience, bring the mercy and love of Christ to others, to each of us, every single day. This demands from one who commit themselves to consecrated life a generous gift of self-surrender, leading to detachment and selfless availability. I'm fond of saying that if we didn't have religious life in the church, we'd have to invent it. Because, as we realize here and there in the Diocese of St. Louis, it's a great gift with 82 religious communities, many present here this afternoon. The sisters teach us, by the way they live, how it is that we can respond to Luke's gospel. Rather than reach out to a world which negatively can affect us in the culture of death, a place where we can feel helpless in the face of violence and poverty, a world which lacks a sense of human dignity. Rather than this false value system, the sisters bring to us, to our world, the good news of our Lord, expressed in the joy which the followers of Christ possess. Pope Benedict XVI, now emeritus, said that the kingdom of God means that God is the living God, who is able to act frequently in the world and in history, and is even now swept. Interestingly, this comes to a surprise to many, that Christ is acting in the world even now. But the truth is, each of us is present here. Oh, I know, you drove yourself and you walked in the door. But actually, each of us is present here through the grace of Almighty God, which helped us to come here in the first place. The sisters understand that, for they walk close with the Lord each and every day. But there's something that they show us that each one of us is invited to do. And that is, as we watch their beautiful vocation unfold, to see their unique relationship in relation to Jesus Christ, we can pause and ask, I see how close the Lord is to this. How close am I to him? And if God seems far away, guess who moved? And if he does seem far away, the presence of these women religious in our midst today remind us that we've got some work to do. Perhaps that happens when, as Christians, maybe in the time of retreat, we can slow down a bit and calculate the cost of following the Lord. And in case you don't think there is one, I'm not talking here about the collection. I'm talking here about the that each one of us is invited to make as baptized Catholics of Jesus Christ. And we see it in the radical commitment of the sisters. As a matter of fact, in another place in the Gospel of St. Luke, we find this fellow who's called to sit down and calculate the cost before he builds the tower. And I like to suggest that we have to sit down every day, perhaps at the time of our morning offering, and count the cost of following the Lord. It affects what we do. And then the most amazing thing happens. Once we reflect on whether we're close or far away from God, and we've calculated the cost, God can open our hearts a little bit, and he begins to introduce us to little moments of conversion, no matter how old we are. Although I have to tell you, I was preaching in Michigan one day, and I mentioned that fact, and this lady in the front row, who I later found out was 83, she was shaking her head. I was getting instant feedback in the homily. And so I was so struck by it, I said, "Madam, you appear to disagree with me." And she said, "I do. I don't need conversion anymore. I don't go to those places." I was intrigued. I said, "What places?" She said, "You're too young to know." But over here, watching the sisters live their vow life, we discover that each one of us is invited to little moments of conversion. And you ask why? It's what we're here to celebrate today with Sister Lamar. The mission, what we're each called to do through our own unique and special vocation, consecrated life, or marriage, or generous single life, or priesthood. We can't escape. Each one of us is called to one of those vocations. And you say to yourself, "Well, I've never heard the church refer to single life as a vocation." I remind you, it took them 2,000 years to say the marriage was one. I'm just ahead of my time. But sisters, that's what you help us do. By the way you live your life, proclaiming the kingdom of God, as God has taught you and leads you to do. For after all, the kingdom is not something we create. It's God's word. And each one of us, through the words of St. Paul, are invited to draw near. And as we fulfill our responsibilities, to come to that point in our life when we can fully, joyfully, alive, serve Jesus Christ. Sister Lenora, thank you for helping us accomplish that. Sisters of St. Peter Claver, following your founders for 150 years. Thank you for helping us with that. May God bless you. And now, Sister Lenora, would you do us the favor?
My Lord and my God, you knew me before I was formed in my mother's womb. For love of you and for your great glory, you called me to consecrate myself intimately to our Lord Jesus Christ and to follow him more closely. I say yes to a mission in different places which I do not know. With all my heart, I entrust myself to this family of the Institute of the Missionary Sisters of St. Peter Claver. Out of devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, to St. Peter Claver, to Blessed Mary Teresa, and out of love for the missions, I reconsecrate myself today to the service of the missions, in accordance with the constitutions and the spirit of the Institute. In the presence of my sisters, I renew now my perpetual vows of chastity, purity, and obedience. I promise my prayer and aid to help the missions, and to follow the example of our families, Blessed Mary Teresa. My Savior and my spouse, accept these vows and these promises, which I have just reaffirmed. Grant through them and through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Peter Claver, Blessed Mary Teresa, and the saints, that I may receive the grace of final perseverance and come to live with you forever.
For missionary sisters of St. Peter Claver, for 85 years, that they may awaken a stronger missionary spirit in all Christians everywhere. For them and for their witness to us, let us pray to the Lord. Especially in the
It is a day of great joy and gratitude that we are here celebrating in this year of faith, the anniversary of Blessed Mary Teresa Lenkowska, who was a woman of profound faith and great zeal in bringing the gospel message to the missions. She wanted that all people know God, love Him, and be with Him for all eternity. And this is why we are grateful to you, Archbishop, for being with us on this wondrous occasion of 150th anniversary of our Mother Foundress and the 25th anniversary of Sister Leonora's profession of religious vows. We are thankful to Father Michael and all of you who made these so glorious, the choir. We cannot forget each one of you here who helped us in so many ways. Your prayers, your love, your support, your dedication encourages us constantly to be completely of you ever behind the front lines of the missions of the Mother Church.
Dear